Morning, friends.
The driving shaft rotates, the driven shaft also rotates through the pulleys and belt. So that means the pulleys are rotating members here. When the belt is wrapped around this pulley, due to the rotation of this pulley, the centrifugal force acts on this belt. That centrifugal force acts on the belt always tries to slip out the belt, or tries to pull out the belt from the pulley surface, right? So hence the tension in the belt slightly increased. That may be a tension in the tight side or tension in the slack side, right? So that increase in tension due to the rotation of the pulleys is called centrifugal tension, right? Which is generally denoted with TC. Right. So let us take a pulley. Mounted on the shaft. Mounted on the shaft. So the belt is wrapped around this pulley to transmit the power. Let us take a small portion of the belt here, PQ. Let us take a small portion of the belt, that is PQ. Right? So the angle of wrap or angle of contact of this portion of the belt PQ at the center of the pulley, let us take delta theta. Right? So as I said earlier, it is subjected to when the pulley rotates. Let us assume that the pulley is rotating in the clockwise direction. Right? So due to the rotation of this pulley, some amount of centrifugal force acts on this pulley surface, thereby belt surface, and the pulley, the belt is always tries to pull outside, and it is subjected to a tension called the centrifugal tension. Let us assume TC is the centrifugal tension at P. Similarly at Q, the same amount of centrifugal tension acts. So this centrifugal tension is exactly tangential to the surface of the pulley. Right? So this is centrifugal tension, and the centrifugal force always tries to pull the belt from the surface of the pulley. And let us assume the centrifugal force is equal to Fc. Okay. Since the belt runs continuously over the pulleys, the centrifugal force caused, whose effect is to increase the tension on both the tight side as well as slack side. Okay, the tension caused by this centrifugal force is called centrifugal tension. So that's what we have discussed, right? So this centrifugal tension is considered when the speed of the belt is greater than 10 meters per second. If speed is greater than 10 meters per second, then TC will be taken into the account. Since at lower speeds, the effect of centrifugal tension is very, very less. That's why the effect is neglected. But at higher values of belt speeds, generally more than 10 meters per second, this effect will be taken into the account. Okay, so to find out the value of this centrifugal tension, let us consider a small portion of a belt PQ right, which is wrapping around the pulley, right? So subtends an angle delta theta at the center of the pulley. Right, now let us take small w be the weight of the belt per unit length. Weight of the belt per unit length. Okay. Similarly, let m be the mass of the belt. Mass of the belt per unit length. Okay. So m is equal to weight divided by g. Weight divided by g. Okay. Let v be the linear velocity of belt. Velocity of belt in meters per second. Then r is the radius of the pulley. Radius of pulley, right? Then centrifugal tension. Pc is centrifugal tension. Okay. So now you consider the equilibrium of this elemental portion of the belt length pq, right? This pq will be in equilibrium when it is subjected to two centrifugal tensions at P and Q, Pc and Tc, along with the centrifugal force Fc, which is trying to always pull out of the pulley surface. Okay, now we know the length of the belt. Length of belt PQ. Length of belt PQ is equal to small r into delta theta. Small r into delta theta. Therefore, mass of the belt. PQ is equal to, right? M is mass of the belt per unit length into r delta theta. So this is total mass of the belt. Then centrifugal force acting on the belt. Therefore, centrifugal force acting on the belt. Belt PQ is equal to mass into m into r delta theta into v square by r. V square by r. Right? So that you can rewrite this as RR cancel. Mv square, right, into delta theta. This is equal to centrifugal force Fc. Okay, now now you consider the equilibrium of this belt PQ. Equilibrium of PQ, right? So PQ is in equilibrium since the vertical components are equal. PC, if this is delta theta by 2, this one also equal to, if this is theta, this is also equal to delta theta. Okay, so here also the angle is same. This is equal to delta theta. Okay, so BC cos delta theta by 2 is equal to BC cos delta theta by 2. This is sigma fy equal to 0. Okay, similarly, then you consider sigma fx equal to 0. Right? Sigma fx equal to 0. Pc sin delta theta by 2 plus Pc sin delta theta by 2 is equal to x. Is equal to Fc. Okay, so implies, but for smaller angles, sine function is equal to sine theta is equal to, for smaller angles, sine theta is equal to theta. Therefore, 2 into Pc into delta theta by 2 is equal to Fc. What is Fc? Fc is equal to mv square into delta theta. Mv square into delta theta. Okay, so therefore 2 to cancel, theta theta delta theta cancel. Then you will get Pc equal to mv square. So that is equal to w by g into v square. This is centrifugal tension equation in the belts. Okay. Right? So what is centrifugal tension? When the belt runs continuously over the pulleys, some amount of centrifugal force is acting on the pulley, thereby belt, and the belt is always tried to pull out of the belt pulley surface, right? And this causes increase in the tension on tight as well as slack side of the belt. So this tension is called, this increase in the tension is called centrifugal tension. And to find out the magnitude of this increase in the tension, so we have considered small elemental portion of the belt which is wrapped around the pulley, and the equilibrium of this portion is considered. So generally this centrifugal tension is taken into the account when the speed of the belt, linear velocity of the belt is greater than 10 meters per second. Okay. Then, so you need to consider a few things as far as this centrifugal tension considered. So, as I said earlier, the centrifugal tension increases the tension on both tight side as well as slack side. So, the total tension on tight side when the centrifugal tension is taken into account, total tension TT1 is equal to T1 plus TC. Similarly, TT2, tension on slack side, T2 plus TC, TC plus T2 plus TC. Okay. So the total tension on tight side as well as slack side slightly increased because of this extra component. So from this, what is the power equation? Power is equal to T1 minus T2 into V. Okay, T1 minus T2 into V. Okay, so now shall I substitute this instead of T1, if I take TT1 minus TT2 into V. So what is TT1? T1 plus TC minus T2 plus TC. Okay, so into V. Then TC, TC gets cancelled. Once again, the power transmission is equal to T1 minus T2 into V. So from this, what inference you can give here? the effect of centrifugal tension on the power transmission is zero, right? Here, so the centrifugal tension has no effect on the power transmitted. So that conclusion you can give from this derivation. Similarly, the third part is what is the ratio of driving tensions? Morning we have seen T1 by T2 is equal to e power mu theta. T1 by T2 is equal to e power mu theta. So here this equation also expressed like this. T1 by T2 is equal to TT1 minus TC divided by TT2 minus TC is equal to e power mu theta. Always the ratio of driving tensions must be expressed in terms of actual tensions on tight and slack sides without considering the centrifugal tension. So that's why T1 and T2 must be considered while calculating ratio of driving tensions in the belt. Okay, so T1 by T2 is equal to e power mu theta. So this is regarding the centrifugal tension in flat belts when the belt is running over the pulleys. Right? I hope it is clear. Thank you.